We are here for our third installment of City of Angels.
City of Angels.
We've got yet another riveting story about another angel that
appearing.
Shows up in the Bible, that appears to somebody. So, super excited about what we're about to learn today. As you can see, we have some treats, but they're not for just yet. As you know, tradition is I play a game with Bagel and I win. So, at the end of the show, I'm totally kidding. This could be the time.
Guys,
this
could be the time. I have a good feeling about this one, but I need you to root
cookies
for me.
Cookies are his specialty, so you never know. Mm. But First things first. Yep. Ayla, you want to pray us on it?
I would love to pray for us. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for another weekend, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the story you have for us, God. Please just speak to us throughout this story, God. Thank you, Lord, for all that you're doing for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. All right, we'll see you guys soon.
Hi there, old chicken nuggets. It's me, Carl. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Whoa, I'm glad to see y'all. Yeah, I've been having some fun since the last time I saw you. Did you notice anything new about me? Anything noticeably different about my appearance that is popping out to you? No? Seriously? I got a new hat. I mean, I know I usually don't wear hats, but I thought, why not? And these glasses are something I'd imagine a fancy schmancy actor wearing in Los Angeles. You lucky? Oh, what inspired all this change? All this wonderful newness? Well, I'll tell you. I was walking around this beautiful city when I realized something. My map was wrong. Well, it wasn't wrong, it was just outdated. You see, I was using like an old map from like 30 years ago. So I was finding streets that didn't even exist when this map was created. Like, look at this for example. You know that Hollywood sign, right? I mean, it's famous. But did you know that it used to say Hollywood Land? I know, I was running around trying to find the Hollywood Land sign. Turns out, that's the same sign. The whole time, that was the same thing the whole time. Come on. Where all this desert used to be, there's like parks and houses and all that kind of stuff. It's all new.
That's what I'm saying.
Jada? What?
I said, that's what I'm saying.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Wait, are we talking about the same thing?
I highly doubt it.
Oh, my bad. I heard you say it's all new and I thought you were talking about... No, what? Never mind.
No, no, I have to know what you're talking about.
Okay, sorry. Well, since we talked about Mary last week, I figured we were talking about Joseph and all that.
Sure wasn't, but now I want to know. What happened? Did Mary tell Joseph about the baby?
That's the thing. Mary did tell Joseph, but Joseph wasn't super pleased about the news.
But didn't Mary tell him about God and the angel? And how this baby was God's son?
Yeah, but I'm not sure he believed her. Or more importantly, he didn't think anyone else would believe her. They all would have been wondering where this baby came from, and it for sure wasn't Joseph. So he was going to leave Mary, even though he still loved her. But then something awesome happened.
Disneyland's letting everyone in for free? Oh, I thought everyone was getting let into Disney for free because you said something awesome happened, and I figured that was it. Continue.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that, but an angel came to talk to Joseph.
Oh, that's way better.
Right? The angel came to Joseph in a dream and told him, "Do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
Whoa, that's huge news.
It really is, and it was exactly what Joseph needed to hear.
So he trusted God's plan from then on?
He sure did. He kept Mary as his wife, and they patiently waited for Jesus to be born. It was all so exciting for so many reasons.
What do you mean?
Well, think about it. The birth of Jesus wasn't something small. Thousands of people for hundreds of years have been waiting for Jesus.
Really? How?
You see, in the Old Testament, way before Jesus was born, there were tons of hints and stories about how a Savior would be born. And this Savior would go on to wash away all our sin. He would make it possible for everyone to know God.
That sounds amazing.
It is. And so when Joseph heard this, he knew that Jesus is coming meant everything was going to be new. People's purpose in life would be new, the way they spoke to another, the way they treated each other, everything would be new.
All because of Jesus?
That's right, all because of Jesus.
I guess that makes sense.
Why do you say that?
Well, I remember when I first started listening and living for Jesus, everything seemed, I don't know, new. The way I looked at everything in my life, it was just like different, better, you know?
Oh, I totally get it. Jesus does so much for so many, but one thing's for certain. Jesus makes everything new. Hey there, kiddos. Today's big idea is super special, and that is Jesus makes everything new. So let's say it out loud on the count of three. But I figured we can do something new. We are having a lot of talks about angels. So when we say it, let's wave our arms like angel wings when we say it, okay? Ready? One, two, three. Jesus makes everything new. Great job, everyone. Next week is Carl's last week in Los Angeles. And I heard he's gonna have a message for everyone. So make sure you tune in to that time, okay? Perfect, I'll see you later.
Thank you for watching and tune in next week for a new episode of RoadTV.
Every week, we have an opportunity to start a relationship with God. You may be wondering, why do we make such a big deal about this? The problem is we are born with sin in our hearts, and every day we commit some sin against God. And sin doesn't allow us to have a relationship with God, who is perfect. But God loved us so much that he sent his son Jesus to die on the cross and take the punishment for our sins, punishment that we deserved. Then, 3 days later, God performed a miracle and brought Jesus back to life, defeating sin and death and making it possible for us to have a relationship with God. So, if you're ready to say yes to Jesus and start a friendship with him, all you have to do is tell God that you believe in him. Tell God that you're sorry and ask him to forgive you. I'll lead you in a prayer. All you have to do is bow your head, repeat after me, and really mean it with your whole heart. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner and I have done many wrong things. Please forgive me for all my sins. Jesus, I believe that you died on the cross for all my sins, that God raised you from the dead, and that you are alive today. So I put my trust in you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. That's wonderful. If you just prayed that prayer with me, you have made the best and most important decision of your life. You are now a member of God's family. We are so proud of you and excited for you. Now, there are two things that you need to do. First, is tell your parent or another trusted adult that you've prayed and to start your relationship with Jesus. Two, we want to celebrate you, so let us know that you prayed by texting the word KID to 240-269-2100. Welcome to God's family.
Welcome back, kids.
Welcome back.
All right, so we learned, sorry, there was something in the air. We just learned about another angel that appeared, this time to Joseph. So, Joseph found out Mary was going to have a baby, and he was a little afraid because he felt like, you know, the situation was pretty much broken. He didn't know if he was ready for this situation. He didn't know what to do. But God is good because he sent an angel to come and speak to Joseph. And what this angel did was give him a word that took away those fears. He told him, Joseph, this is God ordained. God said that Mary was gonna have a baby, and Joseph didn't know this yet, but then the angel gave him the inside scoop that the baby was gonna be Jesus. And then Joseph, in that moment, once he heard that word, God took what was broken and made it new and gave him a new lease on the situation and his excitement for feeling like he was gonna be a part of something absolutely amazing.
Wow.
Which brings us to our big idea.
Which is our big idea is
it is Jesus makes things new.
Totally new.
So, question, Bagel.
Yes.
What is something broken in this world that Jesus can make new?
Wow. Okay. So when we think about our story, we're thinking about Joseph, who was in kind of a broken situation, but Jesus ended up using that situation to do something amazing.
Yes.
Right. And something I think that's a little bit broken could be, you know, the way our relationships with each other, the way we speak to each other sometimes.
Like our attitudes.
Yeah. And, you know, something that the Bible teaches us is to actually love your neighbor, right? Mm-hmm. And I think that's something that we can definitely work on, is just loving each other, like just like how Jesus loves us.
I love that. That's awesome.
And, you know, and especially the situations where we're not sure how it's going to come out, we can't see the outcome, we can trust that all things are working for the good of those who love God.
Meaning us.
Absolutely. And when we know that God can take any situation, no matter how bleak or sad, and turn it into something amazing.
Amen.
Okay, I was getting myself hungry because we got cookies.
It's time. So, what we will be doing is playing with our food today.
Yes.
So make sure you ask for permission. Don't tell your parents we did this. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know. Show them the video.
How do we
play? We're going to put this cookie on our face.
We're getting serious.
Oh, there's so much chocolate on the bottom of this cookie.
Oh, yeah.
So once you put it on your face, you're going to have to try to bring it down into your mouth without using your hands.
Okay.
If it falls off, you start again and put it on your forehead.
Okay.
Whoever gets it into their mouth first is the winner.
Guys, I'm feeling pretty good about this one.
Mine are so warped. Will that be an advantage?
Maybe.
We shall see.
All right. Do we just put on our flags?
And go.
Okay. Oh, this is harder than
I felt a crumb. Can I?
It's like, I feel
can
like.
Can I like choose I don't not know, to do this?
I don't know what to do.
The crumbs are falling in my
eye. This is a weird situation. I want to eat it.
I can't do this, guys.
Ah!
Did you get it? Oh no, I opened my eye and a crumb went in.
I'm close, guys. You know what? This is when we pull through.
I'm gonna drop it. Don't
I'm using up all my energy. Come on. Take any situation. Take the best out. We gotta do this again. There's no such thing as success without failure.
Okay, guys.
This is difficult.
So, tune in next week for our final installment of City of Angels.
Did you do it? Oh. Guys, this one might be a little bit too difficult for me, but I'm still gonna.
You know what? It's an A for effort.
Mm-hmm.
You too can try this at home,
yeah,
with your parents' permission.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we love you guys. It's great to see you this week, and we will see you next week when we will learn more about another angel, and we'll have another activity.
Yeah.
All right, have
Can't
an awesome
wait to
week.
See them.
Bye, guys.